Hi, thanks for coming to the Homeless Youth Count. This is year 2016. It is a joint production between Nevada Youth Empowerment Project and Build Our Center. And what we are looking to do is participate in the HUD Continuum of Care point in time count. It happens all over the country in every county where they want to get an accurate count of homeless people in each area. So in Washoe County, we realized that the numbers weren't accurate for young people living on the streets, and what young people need is so much different than what adults need. So a couple of years ago, I think it's been about 5 years now, we segmented off, and now we run a specific count for young people 18 to 24. Their needs are much different than the adult population, and it's a much more manageable number. We imagine that number to be around 300, although it's hard to know exactly because of the stigma being attached to the word homeless. So with the Homeless Youth Count, what we understand is that the youth have much different needs than the adult population. The state of Nevada hasn't added a youth housing bed in 5 years. Currently, we're already so overloaded in our shelters that there aren't places for these kids to go, and that might not be the safest place for them to stay anyway. So I'm hoping that with these numbers, we're able to really look at housing, affordable housing, which is so important, and focus on what we can provide to these young people to help them build a foundation for their future.
David Bobzing, council member at large, City of Reno. And this is the point in time count that's done annually in our community for homeless youth. And in addition to an outreach effort in which services can be provided and other support can be offered to homeless youth in our community, it's critically important to get counted because so much of the funding formulas that drive support for services in our community sort of begins and ends with this count here. We have to know what the extent of the population is that we can get the funding necessary to serve that population.
My name is Amy McKillop, and I am with RISE, which stands for the Reno Initiative for Shelter and Equality. And we are here just providing toiletries and clothes and shoes, sleeping bags, tents, anything that the homeless youth may need in order to keep them warm and comfortable when they're out on the streets.
How many people do you think will come through here today?
So far, we've had a little over 40, and we are hopeful that we'll have at least 100. I know we're waiting until school gets out at 3 in order to have more students or more youth show up.
So I'm with Northern Nevada Hopes. We are a nonprofit community health clinic down in town, Reno. We offer primary care services for everyone in the community who is underserved and not happy with their current medical care. We offer a sliding fee scale for individuals who don't have insurance, as well as we accept all insurances. We have psychiatric services, psychological services, on-site pharmacy, social services, basic primary internal medicine, and then we're also here today doing rapid HIV testing and syringe service programs. So we are the only operating syringe service program in the entire state of Nevada. So we are helping individuals to avoid getting lifelong infectious diseases from their habits. So we provide them with clean syringes and take those clean syringes back and dispose of them properly.
It's been exceptional weather, which is fantastic. The generosity of people in our community absolutely blows me away. And I know a lot of awesome people, and the people that showed up and contributed and gave their time and their talent, and in some cases their treasure, has exceeded any expectation that I have. So it's been wonderful.